I'm going to show you how to make a cinematic title animation with PowerDirector. Let's move some people with a stunning introduction. First thing that we need to do is create our text. So we'll go up to the title room and we'll left click that with our mouse. Then we're going to locate the default text. We'll hold down our left mouse button over this and drag it down to track one. Now we're going to double left click on this text to open it. And we're going to go ahead and double click in the text box. And we're going to change our text size. And for this, we'll make it 88. And in the text box, we'll type in the text that we want to use. And we're going to go down to the Align Objects button and we're going to left click on it. And we're going to go to Horizontal Center. We're going to left click on the Align Objects button again. And we're going to go to Vertical Center. And now I'm going to scroll down to the Position section. And I think that the Y axis is a little off, so I'm going to change that, move it down a little. And I'm going to go ahead and click on OK. So now that I have my text, I'm going to go ahead and create a snapshot of this text. So I'm going to click on the snapshot button. I'm going to go ahead and give it a name. And I'm going to click on save. Now I'm going to go back to the media room. And we'll see that the snapshot that I saved is in the media room. Next, we're going to create some masks so that we can have certain sections of letters available to manipulate them later on. So I'm going to go ahead and hide this title track. And I'm going to take the snapshot, hold down my left mouse button over it, and I'm going to drag it down to track two. Then I'm going to go to Tools, and I'm going to go to Mask Designer. I'm going to scroll up until I see the full mask. I'm going to left click on it. And I'm going to hold my finger over this node and drag it in so that I'm just over the T. And then I'm going to do the same thing on this side to make sure that both sides of the T are visible. I'm going to go to the top part and I'm going to drag this down. And I want to go below this so that it's just that section of the T. I'm going to drag this all the way up. So now we have just this section of the letter T. I'm going to go ahead and click on OK. Now I need to do the same thing for another letter. I'm going to right click on the snapshot that I just created. I'm going to do copy. I'm going to right click on track three. I'm going to do paste. And now I'm going to go back to Tools. I'm going to go to Mask Designer. And now what I'm going to do is just move this over until it's over the eye. And now I have a section of the eye that I can manipulate as well. So I'm going to go ahead and click on OK. Now I'm going to go ahead and unhide track one so I can see my title again. And now all you can really see is the title. You can't see the sections of the letters that I created. So I need to go ahead and animate those and move them up and down as I wish. So I'm going to double left click on the snapshot on track two. I'm going to make sure that my playhead is at the beginning. And I'm going to create a position keyframe. And for this one, I'm going to change the Y parameters to 694 and hit enter. and it actually moves it down. So you can drag this and move it however far down or up you need to. It's up to you where you want to put it. The only reason why I'm typing in the parameters is because, of course, I did this ahead of time, so I know exactly what parameter I want to use for this part of the letter. Now I want to move my playhead to 1 second in. And I'm going to create another position keyframe. What this does is it holds that part of the letter at that position. And then I want to create some movement. So I'm going to move my playhead to 4 seconds. And I'm going to change the Y position back to the original position, which is 0.5. And so what this will do, if I scrub the timeline, is it will make that portion of the letter move up into place. So now I'm going to click on OK. Now I'm going to double click on the snapshot on track 3. Make sure that my playhead is at the beginning. I'll create a position keyframe. And this one, I want the Y position to be 0.351 and hit enter, and that moves the eye up. Then I'm going to move my playhead to 1 second. I'll add another keyframe to lock it in at this position. Then I'm going to move the playhead to 4 seconds. And I will move this back to 0.5, which will bring it back down to the rest of the letters. I'll click on OK. And now we can play this back and see what it looks like. Now, you're ready for a fantastic voyage. If a cinematic title reveal is a better option for your video, check out this tutorial. Don't forget to smash my cartoon face to subscribe, hit me up with your comments, and drop me a like down below.